Let's go back to the time while you were playing for the Mumbai Indians in 2011-2012. Probably a great time for you, and I have also received a lot of questions regarding that. Tell me about that time. Tell me about the experience of playing with the likes of Sachin Tendulkar, Lasith Malinga, and playing in India. It's a different emotion. Cricket is a different emotion here in India.
Yeah, the effect of me going to India on my life has been massive, not just cricket. Just the everything about India and the way that people perceive life and cricket there, it's just different. And that had a massive impact on me. And to this day, it's still with me. It was an incredible experience. You know, the love for cricket is insane. Back then, the story I told you, when I was around 8, 9, 10 years old, we used to collect these cricket cards and you can trade them with your friends, you know,
yeah.
Those things. And I've told this story a few times to some of my friends. So I had this card. I'll never forget the guy, a little kid, 16-year-old, blue helmet. I think he played like a few tests for India. And I said, I showed my dad this card. I said, look at this guy. He's played only a handful of tests. I'm going to trade him because I can get a better guy. And my dad said, well, if he's 16, he's playing for India, surely. You know, just keep the card. I'm like, okay, fine, I'll keep the card. And that was Sachin, right? And I never threw away that card. I kept it because my dad told me to. And as amazing as it was, and so much going on, as we were walking down the steps there at the stadium in Mumbai, and we got onto the field, as we walked out, the place is exploding because it's Sachin walking out to bat. I'm just the guy batting with him. It doesn't matter, right? And I looked to my left, and as we're walking out, I'm looking at this guy, and suddenly that memory popped into my head of that card where I said to my dad, I'm going to swap this card. My dad said, don't. And I'm thinking, I'm batting with this guy. How insane life is sometimes. And it's an incredible memory. And so calm, and before games, during innings, during over breaks, like, he would just look at the bowler. He would look at the fielder. Even in the middle of over, he would come up to me, would say, okay, they're changing the field like this. So 90% are going to do this now. And the guy would bowl there. I would still manage to get myself out eventually, but I actually had a guy who could tell me everything, the way he could read the game. Now, in terms of batting and as a skill, he's the absolute master. It was incredible. Such a humble guy. You almost want him to be more arrogant, but he was just so nice and so cool. Time for everyone. Any problem he had, he wanted to help you with. No, incredible guys. Everything that I thought of him, it lived up to it for sure.
Is it something that you, the lessons, is it something that you took to your cricket after your time with the Mumbai Indians?
No, for sure. Obviously, planning your innings, like strategizing, being ready to play different every game, every ground, just the way you prepared. He told me a story once about, I can't remember, it was some one day game coming up, but it was like a one day series. And the first game, first ODI was somewhere really hot in India, which is everywhere, but this apparently was even hot for him. So he told us the story where he started preparing his body for it because he wanted to do well in it. I mean, you can only bat 50 overs, so how much do you have to prepare yourself physically? But obviously he knew something was coming. And he started eating certain foods, fruits and all that, certain liquids. Like he prepped his body for that innings and he got 100 that game, I think. So just the way how meticulous he was in everything he did, like nothing is random. Everything he planned in a certain way. You know, the way he played spin, I learned a lot from that. Like, I wish I had that knowledge before I went to India the first time or to the subcontinent, those things. In South Africa, you from a young age, you learn how to play guys bowling 150, trying to kill you. No big deal. But these slower things, we can deal with it, but you need to score. We can hit it, but you need to rotate. So those things you can only learn while you're playing there. And those are things I learned there. And it stayed with me for the rest of my career, for sure.
So did you tell Sachin that story of that card?
Yeah, I told him the story eventually, once we got to know each other a little bit. No, it's an incredible thing. I think about it once in a while. It's the other story I remember about him is, okay, so there was obviously a lot of hype when Mumbai Indians went everywhere, more almost than other teams, because of Sachin, right? So you would have the buses stop at the airport, and then there would be like a security line lining up next to, like almost like a channel you walk through. And within that, sometimes there's one for Sachin as well. And this one guy a younger guy tried to get through just to get to him. And security kept stopping him, and eventually Sachin noticed. And he actually walked up to the guy, said something to him, I don't know what he said, some smile, took a quick photo, gave him an autograph, and he and off he went. I mean, he doesn't have to do those things because it happens all the time. But that's just the kind of guy he is. Yeah, a lot of respect for him. I learned a lot from him. And like I said, in terms of batting and his knowledge and reading the game, no one better.